If you are a wildlife lover, you should by now recognize this place. This is the paradise for wildlife lovers. This is the magical Dikala. Hello wildlife lovers and welcome back to another resort tour from Discover Wild Paws. Today, the hotel we review is very different. It is not a private property which you can book through Make My Trip. This is the Dikala Forest Rest House, built in the heart of Corbett Forest, 45 kilometers away from the city of Ramnagar. This building at the entrance is the camp office of the director of Corbett Tiger Reserve. What a lucky person the director is to share the boundaries of his home with the Bengal Tigers of Uttarakhand. Getting a booking in Dikala for a night stay is extremely difficult. You either need to go through agents who use special software or be very quick with the booking. Let's give you a tour of the reception area first. As soon as you enter the campus, you have to enter the details of all the tourists at the reception register. Then you are assigned a room and handed the keys. If you have a lot of luggage with you, somebody from the staff will assist you to your room. Dikala was opened to public in 1975, but the original building, that is the old FRH, was built in the year 1890. Dikala is also considered to be the launch pad of Project Tiger in India. Tourists are allowed to stay a maximum of 3 nights in Dikala, after which they have to leave. Then they are allowed to come back after 15 days if they find another booking. There are other rest houses between Dikala and Ramnagar which can be chosen if there is no availability here. Let's take you to the famous viewpoint of Dikala. The river is Ram Ganga, the lifeline of animals here. People have seen a tiger from this spot. Isn't this beautiful? The campus is surrounded by electric wires which do not work all the time. So if you come here with your children, take good care of them. Also, beware of the monkeys on campus which will take away any food item you leave unattended. Now when you come to live in the forest, one of the issues is the food. But Dikala is magical. The canteen here is too good and you get all three meals at a price of Rs. 350 per meal per person. You can eat as much as you want. The price is a little higher than what you would find in other parts of India, but the reason is that they are offering you home-like food so deep inside the jungle. Okay, now let's check out the rest of the campus. There are different types of rooms here, but the experience is similar. So when you are booking, go for anything which is available. There is also a dormitory here which is shared by 12 people, but we would not recommend that, especially after the pandemic. Room type number 1 is the annex. You can see how these are all freshly painted and are less than 10 steps away from the river view. We were here during winters, so people put out their chairs in the sun and enjoyed the serene beauty of Corbett. One more thing, there are no network coverage inside the campus. You might get a few bars of Jio somewhere and Airtel sometimes during your safari. Apart from that, your mobile phones will not work inside. But that is the good thing, right? Because it allows you to disconnect from the world, at least for a few days. See, so many langur monkeys all around the campus. If you don't have food in your hands, they will not harm you. But do not disturb them, or else they might attack. Always remember, you are a guest in their jungle. Jungle is their home, not yours. The stair-like structure you see is the Elephant Mound. In the past, there used to be elephant rides for public, organized by the forest department. But now, it has been discontinued. This is still used if the forest guards go to patrol the forest. During the night, these monkeys sleep on these trees. Sometimes, even deer enter the campus at night. Don't worry, a tiger does not come here. Not that it cannot. It's just that the tiger is least interested in humans. He's a shy, solitary beast who rules this place and does not care what you do inside this campus. Yet, it is advisable not to go near the boundaries at night because there are other dangerous animals here too. Now let us take you towards our rooms, and while we walk, let us tell you the different animals you can expect to see during your visit to Dikala. You will definitely see a lot of spotted deer and sambar deer. Then you might see otters as well. If you are lucky, you can see a herd of wild elephants as well. And when you do, try to keep your distance, because you are more likely to be attacked by an elephant in the safari than a tiger. And yes, if you are extremely lucky, you might see a leopard or a tiger as well. Other unique animals you can see are monitor lizard and yellow-throated marten. Our room was at the extreme end of the campus, but it was very spacious. We have come to Dikala many times and we have never been disappointed. But yes, we do carry our own water bottles and snacks here. Take a look at our room now. All rooms have good double beds with comfortable mattresses. The washrooms are fitted with geysers, which is very important in winters. Can you see this view from our room? It's like a dream. You wake up, you open the door, and in front of you is a flowing river surrounded by wild animals and not hustle bustle of the city. One important thing about Tikala, if you come here on a weekend, the prices are 50% higher than that on a weekday. We were three people in one room and the per night cost was Rs. 4400 on a weekday, but 5500 on a weekend. This is the cost of stay, and then you must pay separately for the driver and guide fees. We have added the charges in the description below for clarity. But this is Tikala. Irrespective of the cost it takes to come here, you must once in your lifetime visit Tikala. Bring your parents here, bring your children here, and reconnect with your family and nature. There is also a library inside the campus which was closed because of the pandemic situation. But it's good to see that Corbett Forest Department values library more than our city does. Now there are two canteens in the campus, one which we saw earlier which serves the three meals, and one is this one which offers Maggi, bread omelette and tea coffee. Let's check out the newly built log hut now. It is very different from the rest of the rooms because, as the name suggests, it is made up of wood. We are not sure if this was being used by someone or not. Maybe this is open by now, but it would definitely be fun to stay inside such a house in the forest. Everything except the floor is made up of logs and wood. Behind this log hut is being built a new amphitheater and a day use center. It wasn't open when we were there, but would be a nice thing to have on this campus for children and wildlife lovers. Once the pandemic is over and the people are safe again, this place will be full of happy faces and smiles. Tikala is a top attraction in northern India and we were thrilled during our visit here. We will make vlogs about our safaris as well. In 2 days here, we saw around 12 tigers and managed to capture a few. We showed you the entire campus. Now let's give you a balcony view of Tikala. There is one room type here, which is on first floor. Let's go up the stairs and see how the river looks from there. Similar to Log Hut, nobody was staying here. We have heard that some rooms are reserved for VIP guests as well. Also, during our stay here, we met Sonu Nigam, who was staying in a nearby forest house. These giants you see are domesticated elephants used by the forest department to patrol the jungle. Whenever you see elephants in the wild, be very respectful towards them. Slowly move backwards and don't try to run because you cannot outrun an elephant. We hope you enjoyed the tour of Tikala campus. We are dying to go back to Tikala and hope you are too. Let us know if you have any questions about Tikala booking. We will be back soon with more wildlife vlogs. Till then, keep discovering Wild Paws.